I wanted an excuse to play with Chrome's DevTools Protocol using the accessibility tree as a way to get introspection into content on the web. I did this with a simple TypeScript application that runs Playwright to get a hook on the CDP session, and then does some interesting things with the output of the accessibility tree. The actual output of the application looks something like this. When I launch the application, it goes to afb.org. AFB is the American Foundation for the Blind. And it pauses on that homepage and gives me the title of the page, the number of headings, and the number of links. This is very conventional with screen readers now, with NVDA and JAWS in particular, to announce some basic overview of the page, including headings and links. Then it goes on to describe a summary of the current page and says this page appears to be a hub for information or opportunities related to the visually impaired, featuring links and headings for various resources, including education, employment advocacy, aging services, news and events, and related research initiatives. Also offers opportunity for donations, partnerships, and subscriptions to a newsletter. Social media links are included as well. So the next step is to navigate to one of the links, which is the Talent Lab. And so we get the same overview, title, headings, links, and a new description, which in this case focuses more on the difference between the previous page and the current page. The hypothesis that I'm making is that this comparison will bypass a lot of duplication and verbosity that exists throughout content navigation, in particular site navigation, and verbose heading structure and navigation. There are other ways to do this that are probably preferable. For example, bypass blocks. You've seen skip navigation links, also landmarks. But this is an interesting experiment. I hope to try and explore new options for synthesizing and summarizing page content. So in this case, it says that the previous page focused on a wide range of topics from education to employment to aging and news events, among others. The current page focuses primarily on the future of digital inclusion with an emphasis on internships, apprenticeships, and the AFB Talent Lab. If we look at the implementation, we'll see that I am launching a browser via Playwright. I'm turning on the accessibility tree. And then I'm going to a URL with a hook to this CDP session. And this homepage URL here gets passed into prompt. We visit the page. We interact with the CDP session. So we get the root node. And then we get all the headings, all the links. We store those off into an object and generate that overview that I talked about. Then we call this summarize method. This is what calls out to OpenAI's APIs, and it compares a previous version of this tree and the current version, and then logs it out. One other thing I wanted to show is you can use Chrome speech synthesis to actually read this stuff in the browser pretty trivially.
Tom, American Foundation for the Blind, 25 headings, 55 links. As there was no previous page provided, a comparison cannot be made. The current page appears to be about educational and professional resources for blind or visually impaired individuals.
So I don't know what happened there with the audio. It may come through in the recording better, but it was a little choppy for me.
AFB Talent Lab, American Foundation for the Blind 28 headings 54 links. The current page focuses on digital inclusion, internships, and apprenticeships. It also provides various learning resources and articles.
Great. So that's Chrome's WebKit speech synthesis library that performs speech synthesis in the client, which is a fun illustration of what might be possible with a client-side library that attempts to do some lightweight screen reader behavior.